We now quickly move to a very interesting discussion once again. So we had a very inspiring panel discussion. We're going to build it up from there. I request Molishree ma'am and Bhavesh Kothari to come up and take over for the fireside chat. Can we hear it for both of them?
Good morning, all.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Ah, love the energy. Great. So, Molishree, thank you so much once again for joining in. Thank you, Niti Aayog, for supporting us. I think you know, when we reached out to you and we said, "Hey, look, this is something that we want to do," and the kind of proactive approach I would say the government has been now doing. I still distinctly remember when we did one of the largest summits in the country called Startup Investor Summit way back in 2017. I reached out to Niti Aayog, I reached out to our Honorable Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi ji, and the kind of response that I got was overwhelming. In fact, I'm fortunate to also mention that we actually got a letter from our Honorable Prime Minister congratulating on the initiative that we took to make India as one of the, you know, most preferred destination for entrepreneurship. And also we had a video coming in from Shri Shri to that. So I think the change is happening. And you know, the Fireside Chat is all about how government today is bringing that change and, you know, empowering more entrepreneurs and especially women entrepreneurs as well. So WEP is a platform that is actually nurturing and supporting and encouraging women entrepreneurship. And what apt could it be, you know, a day like this, a moment like this where we could have. So I'm going to maybe, you know, do some fireside chat, you know, maybe talk about how together we could build this entire initiative. So my first question to you is, what are the proactive policies the government is actually taking to make entrepreneurial environment conducive for women entrepreneurs?
About the theory of change, and let me say that I am the first one and the much more believer in that. Why? Because we should understand that change is the only thing which is constant in this universe. And you will all agree with me if I say that our society, our universe, or our aspirations are changing faster than whatever we can imagine. I mean, before answering your question, many of my friends who are settled abroad, they sometimes joke with me and they say that the women entrepreneurs are going on the faster pace than the men counterpart as such. So the time is not far when the term CEOs will soon be replaced by something called she. Ab CEOs nahi bolenge, ab hum CEOs bolenge, because ab hume sari ladkiyan hi dikhti hain ya sab ladies hi dikhti. So, and why is it so? Because in developed countries of the world, I would say in US, we have about more than 30% of businesses being controlled by women. Same with Canada, it's all the more, it's 40%. And with UK and other European countries, 25% of the total business is handled by women out there. And China is not far. They have 5 million, more than 5 million women entrepreneurs, and they comprise of nearly 25% of their overall business entrepreneurship community. But this global phenomena has donned many hats, because it is being a catalyzer of the economy on the one hand, but it is also being a disruptor of the traditional ecosystem which was there in place from the traditional times. Lekin jab hum apne ghar ko dekhte hain to kya hai, bura jo bhula main gaya bura na mile aapko, jo man dekha apna mujhse bura na. So what is the business entrepreneurship community of women in India? Any guesses? Any guesses?
14%.
Yes, absolutely. We have 58 million entrepreneurs and we have only 8 million out of that as women entrepreneurs. And you will be surprised and shocked to see that 80% of these women entrepreneurs who are starting with a business of their own, they are a very self-financed community and they are very small in size and scale. So what is going wrong? We are more than a country of 1.3 billion people out there. And we have nearly about 65% of our age group belongs to demographic dividend, which is 35 years of age. So how can a country progress if half, and we have one, more than, we are teaching our girl child to be educated, to go to schools. So once they join the workforce, when this 150 million joins the workforce, what will be the condition? Where will they go? So how can a country progress when half of its population are not being the partner to the equal growth opportunities? How can it progress if they are not provided a level playing field to realize their aspirations and their place in the community? So this was all in the mind when the GEA summit that you talked about actually took place. It was from here the journey of women entrepreneurship in India started. So Salma, I can't see her here, she's just outside. But I would just like to inform her that, this what she talked about, that every one person has the responsibility of the other two vacant seats. Niti Aayog is supporting Millennium Diva in this cause, and with this videos being online and being uploaded on Niti Aayog's Twitter handle and everything, more than 5,000 women entrepreneurs who are connected with the WEP platform will have a witness to this entire event.
That's fabulous.
So it is bringing more to the community as such. So this all changed. What you talked about, what is the government is doing. So this all changed starting with GEAs.
So, my next question in pops up is, WEP as a platform, what is the approach that you're taking in promoting women entrepreneurship? Is it more from a funding perspective or is it more from an empowerment perspective? Thank you.
So, it's about the entire ecosystem that has been built. And Revati talked about that, we should not differentiate between men entrepreneurs and women entrepreneurs. Why call them women separately? We feel at Women Entrepreneurship Platform, because challenges pertaining to women entrepreneurs are very much different from what pertains to men. So, there has to be a specific place, a specific ecosystem, specially designed for women entrepreneurs to help them to come forward and achieve their dreams. So at Women Entrepreneurship Platform, as you all are women entrepreneurs, you must have realized yourself that there are an umpteen number of stones that needs to be crossed over before the world starts calling it your milestone. बहुत सारे गड्ढे आपको खुद से भरने पड़ते हैं जबकि दूसरा आके बोले कि भाई आपने तो गड्ढा भर दिया शाबाश ऐसा नहीं होता. So, right from conceiving an idea of your own to convincing your family members about those ideas, a man doesn't have to do that. He just thinks of an idea and he goes and starts with a business. Whereas you have to convince the entire family or family, extended family, why you're doing it.
Yeah.
Uske baad, the next thing is that you have to be aware of various financial products which are available in the market. If you don't know that, your business is going to be doomed. Then comes the support from, so right from home, the ladder of biases starts from home. In belief, because they don't believe in your efficiency, to that of a venture capitalist who may be thinking that women are suitable to a few sectors only. So I would also like to tell those investors, if they are out here, that come on investors, the world has changed. It is not 10 years down the line when the Lijjat, Papad and Amul cooperatives were supposed to be the only women driven enterprises. Now you have women who have spread their wings and who have entered into an arena which is more experimental, more wider in robotics, in artificial intelligence, in engineering sector and a lot more. So this was the phenomena of GES 2017-8 Global Entrepreneurship Summit, which Niti Aayog did in collaboration with United States of America. And we all joined together there. And it was a platform that brought together investors, educators, business entrepreneurs from various areas of the field And it gave women, for the first time, it had the theme of women first, prosperity for all. So with this theme, they provided a kind of entire ecosystem. And it was, why was it unique? Let me tell you the two perspectives. First, you had, it was the first of its kind of summit being taken place in the entire South Asia for the first time. Second, 127 countries participated with their educators, with their entrepreneurs, with their investors. And apart from that, we had an all-women delegation from Afghanistan and Saudi Arabia.
Wow.
So here it provided a kind of networking, a solution kind of thing that what there was an entire journey which was taking place. Ivanka Trump was there,
yes.
Prime Minister Mr. Narendra Modi was also there, and it was deliberated quite fervently on what to do about our women entrepreneurs in the country. And it was the idea of one gentleman, Mr. Amitabh Kant, CEO Niti Aayog. He said, right on sitting on the platform, he said, then why don't we have, if there is so much problem, if women need a special system to bring them forward, why don't we have a platform right in Niti Aayog, and it should be called Women Entrepreneurship Cell. At that time, he named it as such, Women Entrepreneurship Cell. And senior advisor, data management analysis vertical, she's additional secretary, Miss Anna Roy, she was sitting right in front, and Amitabh sir said, Anna, you will lead this forward. You will spare this forward. So ma'am said, okay, fine. And within no time, by 8th of March 2018, Women Entrepreneurship Day platform came into existence. So now this brings me to your question that what does it do? What Women Entrepreneurship platform actually does? See, it's a very much unified platform which has all the stakeholders at one place, which will help you to harness the multiplier effects of networking, mentorship, incubation, funding, compliance support, all at one place. What do we do? We have a set of users whom we call our business community. These can be people from 18 years of age to 80 years of age. One of our oldest registrants out there is Ms. Gulshan Nanda. She's a social entrepreneur and she is from Kashmir, and her organization is called Commitment to Kashmir. So they take articles, they take syllables from weavers, and to cut the middlemen out, they sell it into the community. She's our oldest registrant. So anybody who has a probable business idea, which he or she may not be able to, why I'm talking about he, because the enterprise can be women-owned or can be women-co-owned. One of the factors has to be women, so men are not segregated as such.
Fabulous.
So
I think, Billenium Divas was also on the right track.
Yes.
You know, when we spoke about, fortunately we'll have a lot of pitch sessions that will be happening later in the evening.
Right.
And the criteria was very simple for us. You should be either a woman-founded startup or a woman co-founded startup.
Yes.
That is what we brought in. And I still remember distinctly when we launched Billenium Divas, the objective was very clear. We don't want to talk about empowerment. I think women are already empowered,
yes.
Most of them, I would say. We would want to help them and support them because this world is changing. And when we saw that change which is happening, I think we said, look, why don't we also go about in bringing that change and join the moment? So that's where we focus on that. The next question which actually comes to my mind is about support coming in from corporate space, because I think that is very much needed for an essential element for supporting entrepreneurship, and not just women entrepreneurship, but entrepreneurship. So the next question is, what according to you should be the role of private partners and big corporates to promote women in the boardroom?
Exactly. So in WEP, this is what we have focused on. Government of India has not earmarked a single penny for WEP. WEP is a platform which is running in collaboration with these users and our partners. What are these partners? We have more than 30 partners, and these are all corporate sector people, by the way, including government, central ministries, and state governments. So, I told you about the users. Users can be any of you business community members. Other side, we have the partners in the six verticals of WEP platform. So, what are those verticals? these, let me mention partner one by one in terms of the verticals. So incubation and acceleration to handhold support women entrepreneurs in the country. We have tied up with AIM, Atal Innovation Mission, all the Atal Innovation Centers, including AIC Banasthali. So they will provide you the basic incubation and acceleration support. Now, in the compliance vertical, suppose you want to start up a business, but you don't know where to file the registration, how to file a GST. There are a whole lot of compliance issues in the government that you need to comply for. For that, we have ICAI, Indian Chartered Accounts Institutes of India, and we have ICSI also on board. So they have promised a set of two CAs in each of these states who will provide support in filing all these basic compliances. Then you have the marketing vertical. Marketing vertical, we have collaborated with GEM platform also and many other to support our women. Google's Internet Sathi is there to support women entrepreneurs to showcase their product in the market and create a kind of offline forward and backward linkages. And then you have the skilling and the training sessions. A lot many of our corporate partners, for example, like Billenium Divas, if suppose it wants to go for a kind of training and skilling modules, the WEP platform has various online and offline training modules available to teach you how to start up your business. For example, we have collaborated with Deyasra, and Deyasra has given us a kind of the breakup that if you want to start up a beauty salon, by the way. So what are the kinds of equipments you will need? What is the kind of manpower support you will require? What should be the skill of those manpower? What is the criteria or what is the level of customers that you can cater to? So on WEP platform, you will find all these kinds of support, including the funding. We have the Seed Capital Ventures and we have NSI Ventures with Mr. Sushant Singh Rajput. And he has promised 10 crores to the women entrepreneurs who starts business in the artificial intelligence, robotics, and any of these technical sectors. So
amazing.
So there are many people. Sidbi's, Sidbi is a close associate with us. We have collaborated with Seva Bank. India Bulls is there. Stray Infrastructure is there. And these all are bringing funding to the WEP platform. Depending whether your proposal is viable to them or not, if your proposal is not viable to them, WEP also helps you in making your proposal viable by teaching you what to incorporate, what not to incorporate through our entire system, the ecosystem which we have created.
Wow.
So it is being built. It is, we have spent past 1 year in developing this platform, and it is an automatic platform. If you register out there, so you will provide your specifications. I need this, this, and this. The system will automatically connect you with those partners, and these partners will get back to you, and you can directly be in touch with them and scale up your opportunities. Establish your business, scale it up.
That's a whole lot of information. I'm sure it's available on the WEP website as well.
It is. And many of our events are being organized and we are putting, if Billenium Divas comes to us, Niti Aayog is generous for its support. Similarly, if other events are also coming onto us, that is, kind of funding support or any other thing, we are putting it on our website and our registered users can automatically access it and can be aware of the initiative being taken.
I remember my interactions with, maps department. It was a very smooth process. One thing that we missed, I think, keeping in mind the election protocol is DTI's logo. But I was very much assured that we are going to partner forward taking this. So I'm very honored, and feel very proud to mention that we will go forward and create a much more larger ecosystem in collaboration with DTI. So, I was just talking to a man and she said, look, I feel that people like Billenium Divas, people like you who want to make this much more larger, I think they are more than happy to extend our support. So, thank you so much, ma'am, on this. A couple more questions, which I'm going to be throwing from a personal perspective. Who is your role model?
Happy Mother's Day.
I truly believe that we all are, you know, progeny of these wonderful, strong people in our house, in our homes. We have a wonderful legacy. My mother, you know, the strength and dedication, first of all, a child learns from his mother or her mother. So, she was a working lady herself. She was a professor. She retired last year from Bihar University. And there was a time when she used to put, she has to go for college and everything, and she used to teach me that, she used to put a note on bed. And few, because I was very small, I couldn't, ladder up to kitchen ladder to take my food out. So she used to keep it on bed with a note, have your food, do your homework. So, this is the kind of management that you have to teach your child from day one. We are fortunate enough that we don't have to fight for those pitched battle what our earlier generation as women must have fought. Right from the right to education, to right to raise your voice, to right to marry a person of your choice, even to have a right to washroom at workplace. There are many engineering sector, just 5 years down the line, when you have the largest intake into the engineering sector as women, as girl students, but the same does not transpire into the workforce potential and even in the higher space, in the decision making. Why? Because most of these engineering companies never used to have a washroom. 5 years down the line I'm talking about. So even the women had to fight for that. So we are fortunate enough that we are not, fighting those battles on a day-to-day basis. We are fighting now another battles. So it is now our responsibility that we build up a generation and hand over a complete, I would not say a feminist world, I would say a humanist world. We should hand over a humanist world to our next generation. That is our responsibility.
Great. What regret you have in your life?
Nothing. Why? Because I don't have a very sensational story, to be very frank. I am an average Indian girl who had a wonderful mother and who has a very liberal father who gave me all the opportunities in life, do whatever you want. So, but till 10th standard, I was in Bihar, I was pursuing my degree. They had a simple formula. You want to go outside to study, get marks, get going. No, I am not going to roam around in Delhi for you, for schools and colleges. Get your marks, get yourself admitted. And I, as a sincere child, I understood my pain point that, okay, fine, I have to do this to get this, I will do this.
So that's the change, empowering girl child.
That's empowering girl child. And I travelled, I for my masters, I went to Calcutta University. I came back in 2011, I joined Indian Economic Service because I always wanted to be a government servant. My father and mother, they never questioned about it. So there is no regret at all. I have a very simple life, very, smooth life. I have written a book, but that is about a fictional love story. It's not about, anything. It talks about empowerment.
So we have an author also.
Yes. It talks about empowerment, but, I would say it's more about people. It's about how human behavior changes. So it's that. So no regrets.
What proud moment of your life?
When my father said that, you are not known as my daughter, rather I am known as your father.
Wow.
Awesome.
This was my father.
I think it takes back to me 25 years ago when my father did the same thing. When I failed my 9th standard, he said, hey,
look. Can you feel very proud?
Absolutely. I'm not ashamed of that. So he told me, boss, enough of, moving around, enough of fooling around. I think you need to now take charge of your own life. And he said, he sat down with me and said, you know what, I want to tell you one last thing, and I'm sure, you're going to get that message across. He said, when I go out, I don't want you to be known by my name. I want me to be known by your name.
Yeah.
I think that is a change that we are talking about empowering our kids as well. So I think mother plays a very big role. Okay. My next question, coming back to you, is one dream that you would want to pursue? One dream that you would want to pursue?
I would like to be that catalyst or that change, that could empower a lot many people. I joined the government sector for that very reason. I wanted to empower as many people as possible, to help them in your daily lives, that little bit of change. That you should be a factor that says that, ma'am, because of you, my life changed from this to this. This is my dream. That I want to be a source of change for each one of you. And for myself also.
One achievement that you always are proud of.
The many.
Select one of them.
I would not, those are not achievements. They're just achievements is for a day and it passes away, it becomes a history. So you have to work for the next one.
Amazing.
So you should never remember your achievements, remember your failures.
Oh, amazing. My last question is, one message to all women entrepreneurs or to all women in the country or in the world?
See, we as a society need to have a change in our attitude, how we see women entrepreneurs. Why I'm telling this is, let me give you an example. It is very much important that how society treats you. It gives you a kind of perception. When you tell your child, don't even say this like this. So the child will feel that I'm doing something wrong. The same is with an adult person also. How society treats him or her matters a lot. Just let me give you one example. Ambition. Ambition. It's a very neutral word. It does not signify anything in itself. It is the use to which we put to it makes a lot of difference. How? A man achieves accolade in his professional life. He is being awarded by the President of India, for example. Entire neighborhood, entire society, his colleagues, everybody will say, I knew him since this. He was very talented. He was very ambitious. I knew one day he would do something great of himself. He would make out something well of himself. Very nice. As a society, we should be appreciative. Good. Now, imagine a same thing for a woman. She has done hard work. She has done lot of, she has spent lots of nights in office to achieve her dream. Now, she is being appreciated by her boss or by a community. Or by a nation. What do we say? Are we so generous? We say, she's too careerist. She's too ambitious. Ye toh hona hi tha. So, this is the tone and the tenor. Ambition had no specific meaning. But the use to which you have put to it had made a lot of difference for a man or for a woman. So I would like to say all the women entrepreneurs out there that ambition is not a crime. Be ambitious and don't leave your ambition because of anybody or for anybody. It is not worthwhile.
Amazing. Before we wrap this up, there are a couple of videos that I would like to play which talks about women entrepreneurship, which talks about the awards.
One thing you have not asked me, generally people ask me, just let me give you one tone of that. People say that women should be more be more feminist and be more polite, be more toned down. This is our basic virtue. We do that. We should not lose it. But there are some times when you need to be, when I am in office, when I am with my colleagues, when I am with my staff. Government sector is not also an easy sector. You need to get work done. Nobody is there waiting for you that, you order and somebody will get the work done. So you have to get it done yourself. So sometimes you become a little bit aggressive. You become a little bit hyper-toned also. Lekin, tab main yehi kehti hun logon ko, I tone down my staff also at that time, ki abhi chilla diya, baad mein nahi chillaungi, abhi theek hai. Then I tell them that, mizaj mein thodi sakti, lazmi hai sahab. Log pee jate hai agar samandar khara na.
Can you have the audio?
And we are registering for WTI Awards. This WTI Women Transformation India Awards happened last year, 2018. And we honored two people from Maharashtra. Please do that. Which have they journey from NASCOM and all the Pakala, they got solicited by the Vice President of India, and we have also promised that whenever we have roadshows, any kind of monetary help, we have our partners out there who will reach out to them.
Great. Partners. So this is the award.
गुड मॉर्निंग. रोज की तरह आज भी काजल जी अपने आईटी ऑफिस तो पहुंच गई, लेकिन आज भी सूरज ढंग से उगा नहीं है.
सो मैम, दिस इज द थिंग आई हैड बीन प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर, और यकीन मानिए ये सॉफ्टवेयर हमारी कंपनी का सबसे बेस्ट प्रोडक्ट रहने वाला है.
प्रैक्टिकल नहीं है
मैम,
ये फाइनेंशियली वायबल नहीं है, बहुत रिस्की है. डोंट बी ओवर एम्बिशियस.
क्या हुआ तुझे यार? पिछले 6 महीने में मेरे 4 सॉफ्टवेयर्स रिजेक्ट कर दिए. लगता है खुद की कंपनी स्टार्ट करनी पड़ेगी.
पागल हो गई है. बिजनेस स्टार्ट करने में कितने लफड़े होते हैं पता है तुझे? और सबसे बड़ा सवाल, पैसे कहाँ से लाएगी?
राधिका इज राइट.
डियर मैम, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग मी दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. एज आई एम लुकिंग फॉर स्टार्टिंग अप माई ओन बिजनेस, आई एम रिजाइनिंग. विद बेस्ट रिगार्ड्स, काजल शर्मा.
क्या करेंगी अब काजल जी? सिर्फ सॉफ्टवेयर्स बनाने से नहीं होगा, बिजनेस के लिए प्लेस कहाँ, एक्सपर्ट लोग, हैंड होल्डिंग सपोर्ट, लोन कहाँ से मिलता है पता भी है. इंटरनेट पर तो एक ढूंढोगे हजार मिलेंगे, कौन सच्चा कौन झूठा भगवान जाने. सच पूछे तो कहीं नौकरी छोड़कर गलती तो नहीं की मैडम?
वुमन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स प्लेटफॉर्म, ये क्या है? लगता है गवर्नमेंट ने वुमन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स के लिए कोई नया प्लेटफॉर्म बनाया है.
लगता है अभी आधी रात को सूरज उगा है काजल के कमरे में, सही चीज हाथ लगी है. wep.gov.in एक ऐसा प्लेटफॉर्म है जो पहली बार देश की विमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स को दे रहा है बिजनेस करने के A to Z सॉल्यूशंस, जैसे कि इंक्यूबेशन एंड एक्सेलरेशन, एंटरप्रेन्योर स्किलिंग, मार्केटिंग असिस्टेंस, कंप्लायंस, फंडिंग सपोर्ट, सोशल एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, और पता है गवर्नमेंट की योजनाओं की जानकारियां भी. इतना ही नहीं, यहां महिलाएं वुमेन्स एंटरप्रेन्योरियल कम्युनिटी के साथ नेटवर्किंग भी कर सकती हैं, अपने बिजनेस को आगे बढ़ा सकती हैं, या तो नया बिजनेस भी स्टार्ट कर सकती हैं. यहां पर कई सारी अन्य पार्टनर कंपनीज भी मिलेंगी जो वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स को अपना सपोर्ट देती हैं. तभी तो आज काजल जैसी सैकड़ों वुमेन चुनौतियों का दरिया पार करके नौकरी मांगने वालों में से नौकरी देने वाली बनी है. बेस्ट वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योर्स अवार्ड. आज भी मेरा टैलेंट, मेरे सॉफ्टवेयर्स कहीं किसी ऑफिस के कोने में पड़े होते अगर मेरी हिम्मत और मेरे टैलेंट को एक नया प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं मिलता. वुमेन एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप प्लेटफॉर्म, नाउ दिस इज कॉल्ड रियल वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट, इजंट इट? थैंक यू. wep.gov.in
Now you will be proud as a country to know that in the last 1 year since the inception of Women Entrepreneurship Platform, we have a lot many achievements out there. We did V Foundation with mentorship program with V Foundation, which was done at IIT Delhi, and IIT Bombay is still running. And these chosen, the 65% of these applications actually came from this WEP platform for that entire mentorship program. And the 8 top selected were from WEP. And finally, out of the 3 top selected ones, 2 were from WEP, Priyanshi and Geeta Datta. And they received and funding of near about 10 lakhs from DST, Department of Science and Technology. So these are the people who received it. So we have a lot. We have Galilee Institute of Management is doing with us and acceleration program. And the chosen entrepreneurs will actually be sent to Israel for further training and for funding support. So that's why I say WEP is important for you as a entrepreneurship community. And please join and register. And also, if you are an investor like Billenium Diva, would also like to collaborate with it, we are all open for it.
Thank sure, you. We would. I think thank you so much for this invite to us. Amazing. So it's wep.gov.in. Great. Thank you, Dr. Molishree, for joining us here. And it's been an honor to be with you on this particular Fireside Chat.
Thank you so much.
Can we have a huge round of applause, please? I think.
Before I call Dr. Kothari to felicitate Dr. Molishree, ek shayari bolne ka mujhe bhi man kar raha hai. Aur kisi ne kaha hai ki haathon ki lakeeron par kabhi vishwas nahi karna. Haathon ki lakeeron par kabhi vishwas nahi karna, kyunki taqdeer to unki bhi hoti hai jinke haath nahi hote.
Wow.
And I think all the entrepreneurs who are present here are people who are crazy and they have taken the responsibility to do something with their life. Can I please invite Nilal Kothari to please come and felicitate Dr. Molishree. Thank you so much for one more very, very inspiring discussion. Bhavesh, you don't get anything because you are organizing all the things.
I don't think you understand.